Vedas are the oldest manuscripts that we have. So earlier days, if we talk about, the Rishi Munis used to talk on Vedas. There are totally four Vedas, the Rasya, Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda and Athar Veda. So Rig Veda is the oldest Veda that we have and it is collection of mantras. Sam Veda has got the collection of songs, it's a book of songs. Yajur Veda is a book of rituals, the various rituals that is being followed. And then we have Athar Veda, which is a book of spells. So these are the total four Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda and Athar Veda. So as I told you, Rig Veda is the oldest Veda, approximately 3500 years ago. So we have Veda Vyasa, who was the compiler of Vedas. Earlier, Vedas was being recited by the rishis and was given to the disciples. The disciples used to go to the rishis' ashram and then learn Vedas by recitation. That is the process of learning Veda earlier. Later, approximately 200 years ago, they were compiled in the form of written manuscripts. The Vedas were written in a very old Sanskrit, which is not equal to the Sanskrit that we learn in the day-to-day. So, that is how we got the printed versions approximately 200 years ago only. So the next question would be, what is Veda? What does it contain? So Veda is nothing but a book of knowledge. It comes from the word Vidya, which means knowledge. It contains the hymns. Hymns are written in Vedas and these hymns are in praise of lords. So lords are being worshipped by use of these hymns. Okay, there and each and every hymn is known as a sukta. Okay, so there are the gods which were basically praised. Now the question is, who were the gods who were worshipped? First is Agnideva, the god of fire. Then was Indradeva, the god of warrior. And next was Somadeva. Soma is a plant from which you get some rus, somras. Okay, so that also was worshipped. Okay, so they worshipped the gods, the nature, the plants. So they did worship all these things in the form of hymns. These hymns and Vedas was composed by rishis and it was taught to the disciples who were more or less men. They were taught syllable by syllable and bit by bit and the disciples learned it. So there were hardly we find any women being the disciple of any rishi. Majorly they were men but very few were women as well. To talk about the languages that we have, Sanskrit is a part of the Indo-European language like Assamese, Gujarati, Hindi, Kashmiri and Sindhi, all these Asian languages are derived from Sanskrit. Like Matri in Sanskrit is Ma in Hindi and Mother in English. It all is very similar. Whereas if you go to the northeastern part, we have the Tibeto-Burman family. And languages like Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, all this belong to the Dravidian family. The languages spoken in Jharkhand and the central India, they belong to the Austroasiatic family. So there are different languages that we follow. We also follow Indo-European, we also follow the Tibeto-Burman, the on the other side Dravidian, and in the center part we also follow Austroasiatic family. Vedas not only deal with suktas but also conversation, that is the dialogues that they had. For example, Rishi Vishwamitra had a dialogue with the rivers Satluj and Bais who were worshipped. So now the conversation, Vishwamitra is telling, O rivers, come down from the mountains like a swift horse, like two shining cows that lick their calves. So he is comparing the rivers with horses and shining cows. You move like chariots to the sea through the power of Indra. You are full of water and wish to unite with one another. So Rishi Vishwamitra is telling them to come on chariots to the sea and then unite with each other. The rivers are replying, we who are full of waters move along the path and the gods are made for us. Once we start flowing, we cannot be stopped. Why do you pray to us, O sage? So they are asking, the rivers are asking, so the God has made a path for me. So I flow in that same path. Why are you praying for me? Vishwamitra is saying, O sisters, please listen to me. The singer who has come from a distance with his chariot and carts, let your water not rise above our axles so that we can pass safely. So in the reply, Rishi Vishwamitra is saying, so that there is a singer who has come with his chariot, so do not raise too high. The rivers are telling, we will listen to your prayers so that you can cross safely. So the rivers has listened to the prayers. So historians, they point out this hymn was composed in the area where the rivers flow. Okay, so that they also suggest the sages lived in society where horses and cows were valued animals. So that is why he has told the rivers to come on horses and in chariots and as shining cows. That is why the rivers are compared to horses and cows. So like the Vedas, not only are hymns, but also it can be the conversations as Rishi Vishwamitra and the rivers Satluj and Bas. People used to worship cattle. So this cattle you see here, it's goddess Kamdhenu. The cattle provide milk, they were used for grazing and all those things. Cattle were worshipped. Along with the cattle, horses were also worshipped. So horses was a symbol of pride. So they were a part of the chariot. So the chariot is being carried by horses. So you would have heard about Ashwamedha Yagna, which used to be done by the kings, wherein a horse was being worshipped and was left. And if anyone caught the horse, they have to fight with the king. Otherwise, they have to accept the king who has done this yagna is superior. Next, people also used to worship to get children. Okay, they used to worship for children, and mainly they used to worship, they were very much concerned about getting son. So they used to worship horses, cattle, and they used to worship for son as well. Then people used to rule the country. Okay, Jana means people and Pada means step. So where people used to step in and used to elect their leaders. So it is places where people set their foot and follow the rules. So here in the rulers or the kings did not have any capital. They did not collect tax. They did not have an army. And son did not become automatically the Raja. So the Raja was always elected from among the people, that is the Janas. So that is why they were known as Janapadas. Okay. Now to talk about how different people were called. How each and every Janas were called. So we know those who used to be the priest are the Brahmins, and those who used to do the offerings, they were known as Rajas. Okay, so the priest and the Rajas, we know about them. And those who used to compose the scripts, they are known as Aryas. And the people who used to oppose them, they are known as Dasas or Dasyus. They used to work as a slave. So now if we see the group of the people in terms of work, we have Brahmins who were the priests and Rajas who used to do the offerings. The community of people were called as Janas or Vish. We have Yadujana, we have Bharatjana. So who belonged to those group? So they were called as Janas or Vish. Then we also described people who compose hymns. So those who compose hymns were known as Aryans. Those who did not were known as Dasas or Dasyus, who used to work as a slave. Okay, so that's it for this video. I will come up with the lithos, megalithos, and how burials were done, how they were studied in my next video. So thank you. If you have any doubt regarding the video, you can put it in the comments. Thank you.